What's going on, everybody? It's Freedo here for Your Overwatch. If you didn't already know, we have a Destiny 2 channel as well, where we cover Destiny much like we do Overwatch, so if that sounds appealing to you, you can click the link below, or there should be a button on screen that you can click now. But for today's Overwatch video, we're going to be talking about mid-air projectiles, specifically into the context of the Pharah mirror matchup, because it is so important. It'll probably be even more important if Mercy gets a buff, or to counter characters like Junkrat and Doomfist, who both can fly through the air sometimes. And in fact, pros most often take a Pharah battle to the skies, rather than playing sharper counters like Widowmaker, who are flimsy in their own regard. So in many ways, this can be a very big part of your Overwatch skill set. Now, we're not going to have time to cover the decision making of this, of when you should go for the duel, when you should ignore the duel and shoot at the ground. That all could be its own video. Instead, we're just going to focus on being able to hit the shots and seeing when those openings are there, because that is the major key. The most common animation that is the simplest to land is catching the enemy Pharah when she's doing this diagonal flying motion. The secret to using this is knowing that Pharah is basically stuck in this position once she commits to moving in this diagonal way. And it comes from her using a bit of thrusters while directing herself diagonally, and it stretches out and elongates her hitbox, making the rocket easier to hit, but also predicting exactly her flight path. Now, she can let go of the gas and not continue down this path, which might be useful for dodging, but at least for like about a second, you almost always can guarantee that she's going to have a little bit of momentum heading in that diagonal direction. This is important because Pharah players are trying to duck and dodge as they weave around through the air in this sort of semi-circular motion as much as they can. But once you know to look for this specific animation, you've got a pretty safe bet that they're going to continue through in the next second, allowing the perfect amount of time for your rocket to land. Now the truth is, Pharah's doing this dodge technique is better than just floating and not moving, because then you're even easier to hit. But knowing the limits of the hover and how enemy Pharah is going to end up after a little bit of movement makes it not so difficult actually to hit even far prediction rockets. It just comes down to timing, having the rocket connect with the distance you are from them, whether it's 1 second or 2 seconds away, with what place in that animation they'll land. So if they're at the start of the duck and weave, you of course want to aim in a prediction of when it's going to end up. This technique becomes infinitely easier when the enemy Pharah is either running to or jumping out of cover, because their decision-making of what direction they want to go is fairly obvious, and that's half of the battle when beating Pharah, is trapping her in a decision, and at least at the matchmaking level, most Pharahs aren't really going to understand this battle, because they're not used to being contested in air by an enemy Pharah. So they probably won't know when they're making these very clear mistakes that when you look out for, will help you find rocket connection opportunities everywhere. And once you know these things, you're going to end up winning the majority of Pharah battles, at least I do when I'm at my master's rank, probably gonna struggle more when I reach GM and everybody's sick, but this looks even fairly obvious at long range, especially when the Pharah has a decision to either be in cover or out of cover. The thing is, the Pharah can't see anything if she goes behind cover, so you almost know that she's going to have to escape it in that key animation to some degree. You can almost use the amount of cover to just split off all of the possibility of where your shots have to go and carefully line up where she would have to go in order to get back into the fight. Playing a corner as a Pharah is quite good against hit scans, but it's not very good against enemy Pharahs because it kind of like frames the prediction shot. And the last and final way to win the Pharah mid-air battle is more about movement than it is aim, really. And it's about going big or going home and just flying directly at the Pharah, using your movement to get uncomfortably close, hopefully though behind the enemy Pharah if you can help it, because then they won't know where the rockets are coming from, and it's unlikely they'll do some crazy 180 to be able to hit a rocket before you even have the chance to hit your own. Utilizing this technique, it's more important to know your health bar and have control of your movement, because really, if you have 200 health, then it's going to take 2 rockets for her to kill you. So if you can dive bomb the enemy Pharah, jump jet really close to her or concussion blast just behind her, and you know you can hit the first rocket on her, you're so far up in the fight that you're very likely to win it. Now, If you're not comfortable with mid-air rockets, you might then miss the next three or four rockets, and then she eventually kills you. But especially at defeating defensive Pharahs, which I've seen a lot of players really struggle with, at the very least, being able to get any damage on the Pharah quickly, even if you don't outright win the duel by yourself, it can really help ease off the responsibility of your team to worry about her, or can open up an opportunity for her to be finished off by a teammate. We've covered the dive bomb, we've covered the diagonal hover animation cancel. Last thing I want to cover is the spam shot. I'm sure many players assume this is the entirety of the far midair battle, just spamming randomly, hoping that you hit something, but even the spam shots you can master to some degree. The problem is the enemy is going to have so much time to react that if you're not punishing them on a movement animation, they're likely going to be able to dodge anyway, but that doesn't mean you shouldn't visualize and go for shots that you think they potentially could walk into. It's unlikely that they're going to. When you're in the complete coin flip zone is when a Pharah is in midair, no cover around, and she's just floating idly and doesn't overcommit to a motion, there isn't really a good answer because you can shoot right at her and she can just dodge it, or you can do a 1 out of 8 prediction. You can envision like a octagon around where she is and shoot for the most likely next second motion that you could go for. The only problem is if she's looking at you, she's probably going to avoid it entirely. But either way, even when you watch pro Pharahs miss horrifically, as it seems, they are doing this where they're trying to guess which direction they might go. But it's the keen Pharah player that knows when you're in this sort of stalemate to then look to the ground. When the enemy Pharah isn't giving you a clear shot to take advantage of, then you sneak in rockets on the ground. And it's sort of this balance and dance between the two Top Gun pilots that eventually wins out either the ground battle or catches the Pharah with her hand in the cookie jar, looking down at the ground battle too much and then accidentally giving her body up to have a neat prediction rocket land with her face. Guys, I hope this video helped you rule the skies. Understanding how to do this is going to be particularly important in the upcoming meta, I believe. So take your flight school lessons early before the mercy buff comes in. If you enjoyed the video and you found it useful, please leave a like. It really does help us out and lets us know that you're enjoying the content. If you haven't already, please subscribe because we upload each and every day. And speaking of subscribing to things, you're going to want to check out our Your Destiny channel, where we cover the game of Destiny 2, much like we do Overwatch. That's linked in the description. That's been it for me. I've been Freedo for Your Overwatch. I'll see you guys next time.